Texas Freak Tour is probably going to be our most aggressive tour.
Intense headbanging and moshing and sweating like a pig. And then all of a sudden you have to wake up the next day and do it all over again.
We as DC Talk take our tours very seriously.
And the intensity of a DC Talk song, it's made for a live performance.
Our live show is constantly changing.
We're going to try a bunch of new stuff on stage with the look of the show and all.
You never know what's going to happen from night to night, especially with a guy like Kevin on stage. You know, anything could happen. So this is Mrs. Morgan's house. This is the studio. I don't know what the problem is.
Now, Mrs. Morgan, as I understand it, DC Talk describes their music as a schizophrenic pop. Have you ever heard of that style of music?
No, not really.
Me either. It's sort of a catharsis, you know, resolution of inner issues. Do you ever do that?
No, I don't.
It's understandable. Well, you're sort of famous now in your own way, aren't you? How does fame feel now?
Feels good.
Do you ever have small children, relatives running up to the house for autographs?
Lots of them. Signing lots of autographs.
That must be fun. So is it loud living next to a rock band?
Sometimes it gets awfully loud.
Oh, mercy. Do you ever go in there and sit in on some of the sessions?
I have been in there, but all I could hear was a drummer playing.
Oh, so you sort of were checking out the groove.
That's right.
In your own way. I was thinking maybe you could go out on tour with the fellas. You think they'll ever take you out on tour?
Well, I wanted to, but they wouldn't give me my own bus.
Oh, those rascals. What would you do if a mosh pit ever developed in one of the concerts? You think you'd dive in?
I sort of doubt it.
Ooh, rough up some fans. So what about this new group that's moved in next door, Audio Adrenaline?
I understand we're going to have a new group over there.
Yeah, would you describe yourself as having ever had Audio Adrenaline?
Probably not. Probably
have to
not.
Take a Tums, I think.
Probably.
Oh, mercy. Kind of a headache, really.
Our new record's called Bloom, B-L-O-O-M, not Balloon.
Written in Bill's basement, you know, kind of a creative input of everyone.
Spiritually, we want to reach kids. We want to have our music impact a generation of kids.
See Through is a really cool song. I love the way Mark sings in that one.
Hey, this tour is gonna rock!
Enough said.
And hopefully you will think that we've matured when you hear this record. There's Kool-Aid and cookies for everyone.
Heads, AA gets to open. Tails, DC Talk opens.
Come on, Ms. Morgan.
Come on!
It's Tails.
It's Audio Drill and DC Talk. We're coming to a city near you. We're a rock band, and what are you guys?
We are.
We're a schizophrenic pop band.
We're a band.
We're a band.
Be there.
In all seriousness, we would like to invite you to the Jesus Freak Tour for more than one reason. I mean, good art is important to DC Talk, a good live performance, a good record. It's also important to Audio Adrenaline. The truth is, we're guys just like you pursuing a faith. Sometimes we stumble, sometimes we fall. We struggle along, we help each other, we lift each other up. We're dependent on God. Ultimately, our art is an outcome of our struggles and our pursuit of holiness. The reason that we tour and the reason that we make records is because we'd like to share our faith with people. Some of you feel the same way. I know you want to share your faith, but sometimes we don't really know how. Should we go up and talk to somebody? Should we hand them a slip of paper or give them a Bible? I mean, there's all kinds of ways. Our generation, one language that we use is music, and people do listen to music. We want you to feel free to bring your friends that have no idea about your faith or have no idea who Christ is to our show, because that night throughout the night, they will hear about a relationship with Jesus. Music is our tool. The message is Christ.
I'd like to introduce the fat new video from DC Talk, Jesus Freak. It's Funky Fried Diet into the side.
Deep-seated in the American citizen is pride in his community as an expression of all that his country stands for, individual independence, with respect for the rights of others, born of the concept that all men are free and equal.
Separated, I cut myself clean from a past that comes back in my darkest of dreams. Been apprehended by a spiritual force and the grace that replaces all the me I behold.
I saw a man with a tag on his big fat belly. It wriggled around like marmalade jelly. It took me a while to catch what he said, cause I had to match a rhythm of his belly with my head. Jesus saves is what he waved in a typical tattoo green. He stood on a box in the middle of the city and he claimed he had a brain.
What would people think when they hear that I'm a Jesus freak? What would
death is gain. I've been marked by my maker of peculiar display.
What will people think?